If nothing can be faster than the speed of light, why don't we just make the speed of light faster? Hey there, speedsters. Julian here for DNews. Unless you're a certain comic book character who keeps messing up the timeline, Barry, you can't go faster than the speed of light. It's the top, the be-all, end-all of speed, and nothing can go faster than it, including itself, and it's always been that way, period, end of story. Or is it? That's what theoretical physicists at the Imperial College of London are trying to figure out. Decades ago, they proposed that the speed of light may have been faster in the early days of the universe. They weren't able to test their prediction because instruments weren't sensitive enough to precisely measure the cosmic microwave background radiation, aka the light left over from the Big Bang. Now, you may be wondering, why would they even think the speed of light might have been different at any point? Well, all across the universe, the cosmic background radiation seems to be about the same temperature no matter where you look, and this is puzzling. For that to be true, photons across the universe must have interacted and settled into an equilibrium, but given the size of the universe and the speed of light, that's just not possible. The most commonly accepted way to get around this so-called horizon problem is known as the inflation theory. This idea states that when the universe was just 10 to the negative 35 seconds old, so a decimal point with 34 zeros and then a 1 seconds, it expanded by a factor of 10 to the 26, which is an insanely bigly number, and it did it in a fraction of a second before chilling out and expanding at the much less ludicrous speed we see today. That means before the universe stretched out, the photons could have been in equilibrium. The inflation theory is so popular because it solves the horizon problem along with other issues the Big Bang theory presents. But there's another way around this problem. What if the speed of light isn't constant? Why not have light just move faster? That's what these scientists are trying to figure out, and it would challenge a huge precedent. See, one of Einstein's biggest breakthroughs came with the discovery that light is always traveling at a certain speed, specifically 299,792,458 meters per second. I don't care who you are, where you're from, what you did, as long as you measure the speed of light, it'll be that speed. If you're driving at 100 miles an hour and turn on your headlights, the photons coming out of them don't go 100 miles an hour faster. Einstein realized if the speed of light is constant, then space and time could be flexible parts of the equation, and the theory of special relativity was born. And this constant speed thing seems to hold up no matter what we do. Now, some of you may have heard stories about scientists slowing down light, but they're not. Not really. When light goes through a medium like water or a pane of glass, probably how you've seen light slowed down, the photons themselves aren't traveling more slowly, they're just bouncing off the atoms and taking a less direct path. It's why when they leave the medium, light travels quickly again instead of staying at its slowed down speed. This illustrates why people usually specify that there's nothing faster than the speed of light in a vacuum. So right now, the speed of light seems pretty darn fixed, but so does the rate the universe is expanding. 13.8 billion years ago, when the universe was brand new and the rules were like the Wild West of physics, maybe one of those things wasn't so steady. When our instruments are good enough, we'll test this new idea, and if it's wrong, we'll stick with cosmic inflation. And if it's accurate, well, we're going to have a lot of rethinking to do. If cosmic inflation theory is true, then there could be parallel universes. To learn how and see me in triplicate, check out this awesome 360 video we made on the topic. So which makes more sense to you, insane inflation or an up speed of light? You can let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and we'll see you next time on DNews.